ba buipela ho khefuri kopane le bahalolwane ba fumane monyetla wa hore ba buisane le Nandos e le mong wa Gas Bricks mabapili di tena tseo a sa ditlisang
ba bui ke tsapa rona le ditse le rona le jwale ha jwale he re tetswe ke setsebi sa rona setsi biwang haholo mona hae e le Millie Feljoen wa ho tswa Gauteng Department of Economic Development. Millie, how are you?
I'm good, thank you.
Another case where a supplier does not deliver on the agreed time. How do we deal with this going forward?
I think it's, again, just one of those situations where the suppliers has just contravened the Consumer Protection Act.
Mm.
And specifically here, Section 19, that says that the supplier must deliver the goods to the consumer on the agreed time, at the agreed address, and in a condition of good quality.
Mm.
So he failed here. He failed the consumer, and it's unfortunate. But they should insist that they get full delivery of the bricks because it has been paid for.
Mm. But now here's where I get confused now. Now, there was an agreement between the brick manufacturer and the consumer. Now, there's no contract that's put in place to specify that they want this type of brick. How do they overcome this challenge?
That's why we say that make sure there is an agreement. You know, there is some sort of a contract that will clearly itemize what needs to be delivered so that both the supplier and the consumer will then be guided by this document should there be any disputes.
Now, how does a refund work in this kind of arrangement?
So in this particular situation, so we're looking at Section 54, they're entitled to a refund, but how the refund then works is that it will be the refund set off the amount or the value of the bricks already delivered. So in this case, so which means it's 9,000 rand that they've paid minus the amount of bricks that was already delivered.
But now, even the 500 bricks, it's not the brick that they wanted.
This is where Section 20 then comes in, where we say that if goods are delivered, but it's not fit for purpose, and it's not of the quality that is agreed between the consumer and the supplier, the consumer can return the goods and must then get a full refund.
Now, Millie, there are many people out there who are faced with the same predicament here. As GDED, how do you deal with this scenario, the GDED way?
No, that's good. You know, we really encourage consumers to make use of our services, and they must remember it's free of charge. As much as we assist them with complaints, we're also proactive in the sense that consumers can also come to us for advice before they enter into contracts, you know, into sales agreements, into installment agreements, into purchasing anything, and we'll be able to advise you or refer you so that you make an informed decision. I think that's very important.
Right. Okay, so Millie, please allay our fears here as consumers. What happens when a supplier fails to deliver that which you have paid for?
I think the plea is really with businesses, because otherwise, you know, we have a scenario that we can take them all the way to the consumer court. And if they do not honor, for example, a court order, then there's penalties that may be levied against the particular business, or possible imprisonment, or both. So it is really in the interest of the business to take full responsibility and to be accountable to the consumers. And it's not in our interest. We don't want to see any business going under.
Yeah. Millie, you've said it all in a nutshell. Thank you so much for joining us again.
You're welcome.
How sites di tshebeletso ka mgo le dumelaneng ka teng wena le consumer. Ho sotla ya tronkong. Ha re bone he taba ya bahalolwane.